I'm sitting because I have a back problem, and I won't be able to stand. So, forgive me. Can you hear me back there? All right. I was blessed with a big mouth. So, we're going to start the film. I want to show you a film to get us started, and then talk about the ministry of the Lord through charity. When we look at the goals of the church, I think one of the ways to phrase it, and this may be simplistic, it is to be the church in this community. And so we look and we see that there's the barrier of safety, there's the barrier of education. We've started what we call our ICANN achievement camps. During the school year, we are open from 3 to 6 during the times that children need a safe haven. And during the school year, we work with homework completion. In the summertime, our ICANN achievement camp switches over. And this is where we're unique. We focus on reading and math, not on recreational activities, although they get some, not on projects, although they get some, but we focus on reading and math, because what is going to help our children tomorrow as they're adults is going to be reading and math. The other thing we notice is that there's a tremendous migration within the city limits of Detroit. Families are displaced and move to another residence or in with family, and then a few months later they move again. So we know that stability and that housing is a barrier in people's lives. And so we formed our own nonprofit to get involved with housing. We started with $0, just faith. And we now own 4 houses.
Developing a mission to fix up older homes in Detroit and offer them to low-income families. And we just thought, my wife and I thought this was a great opportunity to help, and we came to the first meeting of Charity Incorporated, and here we are now, working on our first home.
The challenges of this type of ministry, though, and in this community, are immense. Being the church doesn't give us total access to resources. We need more people, not only to stand with us in our projects, but to stand behind us financially. As a church in the community, we've developed a reputation with the police agencies, with the neighborhood groups, with City Hall, and that gives us a chance to receive feedback. It also gives us a chance to listen to the community and hear what they're saying about what's going on in the community.
The Department of Neighborhoods has been in existence under Mayor Duggan's administration, so it's entering its 5th year of existence. And I think that's really the history of the relationship of the mayor's office and charity in particular. And especially, I think, embracing the role of churches like this and pastors like Pastor Steve, and how valuable they are, again, in being that link. So now we look to how can we help them help the neighborhood.
There was a need for a block club because we could see our neighborhood deteriorating. It wasn't being well kept. We had people moving in and out frequently and not really valuing the neighborhood as we wanted it to be maintained. Having a consistent place to meet and has been very, very beneficial.
Well, people say to me, well, you're working in a bad neighborhood in a city like Detroit. Isn't it terrible? Don't you rather it be someplace else? And I said, no, because you know what? Right here, every day, I get to live the book of Acts out of the New Testament. We get to be the church. We get to see people's lives changed. We get to see miracles.
It takes more than 2 or 3 people in order to enhance the area that you want enhanced.
You have services with the city that are here to help move that forward and kind of fill that void once again.
It's just giving back to the neighborhood, bring the neighborhood together. It's the light of the world here with Jesus.
People talk about the Detroit experience. You rarely hear them mention the word joy. I'm telling you, there's joy in Detroit if people will join with us and make that happen. Late last spring, at a district convention, President Harrison made the comment that we should plant churches in Lutheran-friendly zip codes. Well, folks, welcome to a Lutheran-unfriendly zip code. Mount Calvary is in zip code 48205. Charity shares, although we're not officially of that zip code, we're across the street from it, so our people live in that zip code. And that zip code has been immortalized by the Detroit rappers as 48205. Within that zip code, there's an 8-block area that is known nationally as the Red Zone because of the gang murders there. You can imagine what the red signifies. I'm astounded. But folks that constantly tell me, well, you know, it's just not safe to go work down in Detroit. You know, they just kill each other. But one, that's not true. My ancestors wouldn't come from the Netherlands until the Civil War was over because they thought everybody in America was shooting each other, right? It's not how it works. But I want to tell you something. That neighborhood, people of God are afraid to work in that. That neighborhood is where children play, where they grow up, where Jesus loves them and is waiting for you to help share that love. In the 21 years I've been at Charity, I've held too many funerals that didn't need to be. I got a call one day from a young lady that wanted to have a service for the father of her child that was killed in a drive-by, and she told me I was the 8th church she called, that the other churches wanted too much money, and she asked me how much I wanted. And I said, zero. Let's make arrangements. I hosted the funeral for a senior at Denby High School who was shot to death on New Year's Eve. And that day, our church was packed. And I don't mean how we think of packed. I mean the pews were packed. The aisles were packed. The choir loft was packed. The overflow was packed. I had to leave the church building and walk around between the front and back in order to help with maintaining the funeral. And as I was doing that, 75 to 100 people were standing in line in our parking lot waiting to pay their respects to this young man. And Denby High School had to come to Charity to ask us to provide the facility. I could go on. I have children growing up in our church whose fathers have been murdered. I have children who have watched people being murdered in the park next to Charity. And the answer to that is to take the great power of God and offer them love. For the church to partner with other organizations. We partner with LCMS. For the ICANN program. We're their oldest ICANN site. We were their original ICANN site. And Wednesday was our second day of the school year ICANN, and there were 9 children in our tutoring program. And as I looked at those 9 children, I realized something. Every one of those 9 children live in a house that our nonprofit has reclaimed from destruction and offered as a safe haven to that family. Every one of those nine children, Ready Church, they've been baptized at Charity. And I say that because that's a crucial part of the ministry and our vision for ministry, that we have to bring it the full circle. It's not enough to feed the kids daily at our iCamp program. It's not enough to just put a house over their head. Okay, we're taking care of them in time, but we need to take care of them in eternity. And it isn't always easy. Our last family moved into the house in February, and I worked and I ministered and I prayed, but it wasn't until October that those six children were baptized at once. So if you pick up a brochure, you'll see that I think seven kids from our houses have been baptized. It's now up to like 14, 15 kids that we've baptized. And I'm thrilled, because there where Satan has brought the darkness in our communities, we're raising up little Lutherans. And I want to share with you, how am I doing, Debbie?
You're good.
Okay. Every tutoring session, every ICANN session, when the children eat, they do three things. The first thing is they speak in affirmative. And they say, I can be somebody if I want to be. All I have to do is work at it, and I can be somebody. And that's where the I can comes from. They then pray the Lutheran Common Table Prayer. Okay, and it's really funny because they're shouting, I can be somebody, and then they fold their hands. You know, come on, Lord Jesus. You know, right? But when they get done with that, they say another affirmation that I think is even more important. They say, I am somebody. God made me. Jesus saved me. The Spirit is in me. I am somebody. And that is the message we need to take to those Lutheran unfriendly zip codes where Jesus walks. And let these children have the self-esteem of being somebody that only comes in being redeemed by Jesus Christ. We have along the wall brochures that look alike, but one is for our nonprofit, and one is for the work that we do through Charity. And I urge you to pick them both up. There'll be information on there how you can support us. But I'd close by saying, I'd love your donations, but I covet your prayers.